Hello, Pogo. How are you? Friday. Friday feeling. Friday feeling for some Nancy Drew. If I can do any of these puzzles, because it's really hard. They went hard in this game. They said, go hard or go home. My poor computer has been downloading games from last night. And then I turned it off during the night. I paused the download. So I think it did about 6 hours of downloading stuff yesterday. Had a little sleep. And I set it off again this morning. It's done Starfield and the majority of Baldur's Gate. Three. The problem is, I don't know why, but I don't know if my internet... I need to look into my settings or something, because something is definitely capping my downloads from the Microsoft Store. Because they were capped at like 10 megabytes per second. And I'm downloading from Steam and it's at 30. I'm doing good. Hi, Moomin! What are you doing? What? What? Oh no. Tech nerd. I'm not a tech nerd. I'm not very good at tech. Just, you know, but I'll try. I'm sure somebody will be able to help you. Let's have a look. Also, hello, Pew and Bread. What, Moomin? I thought you were in it. There are some techie people who watch, who are more techie than I am. Cute little cat sat here. What are you doing, Maisie? You can't even get a 10 megabyte download speed. Let's cry for that. It was as low as 3 when I was trying to download Starfield. I don't know what's up. Okay, let's get into Nancy. Let me get it all sorted. Let's have a look, actually, Pew and Bread. 16... What's its... 16 gigabyte RAM. I think it should. Baldur's Gate 3 specs, let's Google that. PCs. Yeah, you only need 8 gigabytes. And you need... your graphics card, What's its... One terabyte SSD, 16 gigabyte RAM. I think it should do. I think it's not going to be rapid like people who stream it and stuff. I think they have two modes. One's for they have a performance mode and then a stability mode. You would probably have to run it in stability mode on it. But I haven't played it yet. I've got it downloading now, Baldur's Gate 3. Option 2. Wow. That's... They're not wildly different. Let me have a look. I can't see, I remember on the first one. When I researched mine like 2 years ago, this is based on remembering what was good back then. I only really looked into Nvidia, so I don't really know for the first one, but the second one, that's a decent graphics card. Hello, Chimkin. Yeah, but I'm gonna say there's not a huge difference between the two. You're still working. Me too. Me too. I'm working, totally. I've not got my work laptop on the floor and wiggling the mouse around. It's Friday. It's fine. I finished in 25 minutes. I'm burnt out. I'm so burnt. But yes, my feeling pure and bred is both of those would run Baldur's Gate 3. Okay, let's get started with Nancy. There we go. That's the screen. That's the screen. Victor did it. That's our prediction. Mine and Pogo's. Okay. We got a floppy disk that we need to read.
Did that.
And we need to investigate the... No, 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 no. No tech support. Just... Very limited knowledge based on when I got my computer, like almost 2 years ago, from what I remember, because I did a heck of a lot of research. But I do believe you're good. No, sorry. I'm sure you can find like a YouTube video from a craft channel teaching you how to turn it into a freezer instead. I hear those are all the rage. Okay, I don't know what time of day it is in the game, but I guess the one way to find out is see who's about. Okay, it's daytime. Oh, see, what you have to do is you have to chop your head off and then put it in.
Yeah, what?
This is not advice. Please do not do that.
What was your relationship with Nico?
I knew him. Same as anyone else here.
I don't buy that. Victor told me he was instrumental in getting you this job.
Could be true. Strange world. Crazier things.
What did I just say? Hello, Bam! You heard. To fit your head in the microwave, you need to chop it off. And while that may be true, I do not recommend you do that at all. Hello, Light! No! Nobody. Nobody listen to me.
Who was here the night of the murder?
I was.
Who else?
Ellie and...
We have to get out of it.
And who?
Computers say someone, but the cameras say no one else. Nico walks in that door alone every time I watch the tape.
How many times have you watched the footage?
Don't know. Lots.
Why?
It's my job.
Well, you know, I'm saying you could. That's how you should. That's how you could do it, not how you should do it. It's an option. That's how you could get your head in the microwave.
What do you do here?
Job description says security agent. Suppose it's more valid than not.
How long have you worked here?
Don't know.
Can you estimate?
Nah.
You're really not going to tell me how long you've worked here.
So it would seem.
When will someone be nice to us? Ellie's the least awful.
What do you think of Ryan?
Hater.
Why?
You're smart. Carry the sums. You'll get it.
I also hate her, so I understand.
You mentioned rewatching the video. Do you think something is hidden there?
Not hidden. Missing.
What's missing?
It's not a what, it's a who.
I don't understand. Who are you looking for?
Nico's killer.
So basically, Chimkin wanted to know how he could get his head in the microwave and close the door. And I said you'd have to chop it off. And then I said, but do not do that. As a little warning. You never know on the internet.
Did Nico's work put him in any danger?
Yes. Energy is power. Ultimate power.
Why would that put him in danger?
People who want power will not hesitate to get what they want.
There's been a murder, Bam. This is one of two Nancy Drew games that are about murder.
What do you think of Mason?
Don't like him.
Why not?
I got my reasons.
What are they?
Secret. No, actually, I hate him because he's up to something.
What?
I have no idea. Not for lack of trying.
You and Nico were friends, weren't you?
Friends?
Yes.
I guess that doesn't matter now, does it?
I'd still like to know.
Fine. Then just give me a break. All right, champ?
Fair enough.
There was a time when we were friends.
When was that?
Back when he was alive. Now beat it. Give me some empty space to stare through.
Bam's involved now. Bam's complicit in the head chopping microwave situation.
Why were you so concerned about what Mason was up to?
He was messing with tech he didn't understand. I had to make sure he didn't do anything stupid.
The log says that one additional person entered the lab the night Nico died.
I know. The question is, how do you know?
Police report. What I don't understand is why the police didn't follow up on it.
They did. Said it was a glitch.
Do you believe that?
What's it matter what I believe?
No.
It only matters what they believe.
Goodbye.
Bye.
No one lies on the internet. No one ever has and no one ever will. How will I listen to this? And they've got this key. What is it for? Wait. When is it? What is the time? Who's around? Not Mason. It's Ellie. Okay, it's night time. I'm very confused by the security guy's hours.
Hello. I'll let you go. Goodbye, Nancy.
Okay, I'm gonna make it go to the daytime so that I can see if I can use this bin key in the room that Ryan's in. Because I have no idea where else it could be useful. Yeah, I guess so. I don't know when this one came out, actually. Let's have a look. Nancy Drew, Deadly Device. It's the 27th. And there's like 33. It's 2012. Oh my gosh. Just chucking wires everywhere. Yeah, it's not bad. Not bad. Okay. Footsteps.
Who's there? Hello?
Oh my god!
Who was that?
That's just got to be someone trying to scare us, right? Because they didn't try very hard. They just rattled the door a bit. Oh my god!
What's happening? Are you okay?
I'll never be okay again!
What is that thing?
An abomination of technology! It's some creepy robotic cat that someone, I suspect Mason, is tormenting me by leaving all of its awful parts everywhere!
I've seen one of those before. If I find all of the pieces, I bet I could put it together.
As long as you promise to throw it into a fiery volcano once it's completed. That thing is the undisputed mayor of Nightmare Town.
Okay, let's ask her some questions.
Victor mentioned you were arrested the night Nico died.
Yes, I was.
What happened?
It's not a night I like remembering.
I'm sorry it's unpleasant, but can you tell me what happened?
They dropped me in a room and asked me 100 times if I killed Nico.
That must have been hard.
The questions kept coming faster and faster until I had a hard time remembering what was even true anymore. Then it was over. The older one drove me home, told me they'd be back the second they could prove it was me. Made it hard to sleep at night.
What evidence did they have?
They wouldn't say. It was like they were waiting for me to tell them why they thought I was guilty.
I'm kind of wondering the same thing myself. I don't think you're telling me the full story.
What do you want?
Something. Do you have anything that can prove that you didn't kill him on purpose?
No.
So, she's the police... The police's number one suspect. Which means it isn't her. But she's still annoying. And also, she created the machine that killed the guy.
That was quick.
Do you know how I can play a media card?
Yeah, Nico's personal player. I meant to fix it earlier. Get me some Coco Mellows from Nico's office, and I'll have it working for you.
Okay.
From the candy machine? How exactly does that thing work?
Here, this should do the trick.
Thanks.
Yay, we can go and fix that.
What happened on the night of the murder?
Can you not say it like that, please?
I'm sorry, I don't know if there is a better way to ask about something like this, but I do really need to know.
I know, you're right. He talked to me. More than once.
I'm not sure I understand.
He didn't talk to most people. I think he liked me. Or at least trusted me.
You still haven't told me about what happened that night.
We lost one of science's brightest minds for a
stupid
reason I don't
understand.
I think
Nancy's voice acting sounds so weird in this one. Like, she sounds like she's in a cave reading her lines. I don't know, it's just me, but she sounds really weird.
Can you tell me about what happened with the equipment you built for Nico?
It worked exactly as it was supposed to.
Tesla coils are not supposed to be wired like the one you built for Nico. It's extremely dangerous.
You don't have to tell me that. I know. I knew. He told me that's what he wanted.
I don't understand why he would want you to build something so deadly.
I didn't either. He said he was going to do it with or without me. I just figured that if I did what he wanted perfectly, it'd be better than if he got help from somebody else.
In the end, your machine is what killed him.
No. Yes, but...
But what?
I didn't... I would never hurt anyone, especially not Nico.
Why? What made him special?
Because he was brilliant. He could look at a blueprint and know the finished product's personality. And he had no one in the world looking after him.
You snuck in without logging in the day before the murder. Why?
I lost my key. It happens.
Isn't this place extremely well secured?
The labs are. Building... I have my tricks. And no, I'm not sharing.
Bye.
Later.
Okay, I can't see anything in here that would require a key. But she has given us something we can do, so that's good. We can fix the candy machine. Another robotic cat. Well, I don't think this one is quite like the one in Shadow at Water's Edge. Is that what it's called? But this does have a robotic pigeon. Okay. Is this... No, it's not related. I thought I was going to say, is this related to the candy bar? Or maybe not.
It looks like
no.
A memory lock.
Oh no, not memory. God. Oh my God. I can't remember how many times we... No, it's timed. Is it the same pattern every time? Okay. Okay, that was pretty easy. What did she want? Coco.
Ryan asked for Coco Mallows.
Yeah, where are Coco Mallows then?
Great. Just what Ryan wanted.
Will I have to do that every time I want chocolate? No, that's cruel. What a cruel and unusual punishment. Oh, Pogo, stupid internet. I am going... Stupid laptop, always turning itself off. Talking about my work laptop. Bad laptop. Okay, let's give this to Ryan. Ooh.
Is this your motorcycle?
It's my sweet ride! But it's not done yet. But I'm working on it.
Okay, well, that's pretty cool, but I still hate her.
What's that?
She's a tryhard.
Here's the candy bar you wanted.
Great. I'll start fixing it right now.
That's done.
Oh, we can snoop.
Haven't done that.
Spare USB drives. Well, you can't, there's nothing, she doesn't really keep much on her desk, does she? Steal her motorcycle, Nancy. Turn to a life of crime. Getting around in this one's quite annoying, though.
Hey.
Have you been tormenting Ryan with a robot cat?
I'd never do something that hilarious and definitely deserved. Never. Not ever.
Don't you think you should maybe stop?
This guy is actually the worst.
No, I will not stop. I asked her nicely to build it for me. I even offered to pay her for her time. She's the one who hid it, so I don't even feel a little bad.
You look a little upset.
Someone moved my thing. Someone will pay.
It was me. Yes. Take that, Mason.
Who was here the night of the murder?
Not me. So, you know, no follow-ups.
Where were you?
Out on a date.
Did the police follow up with her?
Yes, proving that she does, in fact, pick up her phone on occasion.
So, I take it the date didn't go well?
I have so little patience for the dating scene. I prefer to get right to the important compatibility questions. Kids, when, how many, gender preference, favorite foods and vacation spots. Some women find this to be a bit much.
Some?
So far all. But I only need one perfect or near-perfect match to validate the entire system.
True, Pogo. Unless the ground floor is like underground and then this floor is like the entranceway. That's the only thing I can think. And that's like a garage? A garage? However you prefer.
Ryan said that Nico would talk to her. Does that seem true to you?
No. The two of them hanging out? Can't picture it.
I'd better get going.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Okay. Spit on the back of his head. Ptch! Ptch! That's what we think of you, Mason. We hate Mason. But honestly, I hate most of them in this game. Ellie is the only good one. And I don't know, it doesn't seem like she's very involved. It might be her, to be honest, since she's the only likable one. It would make sense.
Hmm.
What am I doing? Oh, I wanted to go in that this guy's office. Has she fixed it? Yay! Okay, let's listen to the dead guy's diary.
It's Wednesday. I've clocked 49 hours of work this week. I found another note from Ryan on my door this morning. This time, a threat. She continues to surprise. She's smarter than she looks. And then later, she confronted me by the couch in the lounge and handed me another of her threats. I didn't bother taking it with me.
Oh. Let's listen to her yet.
It's Wednesday. I've clocked 49 hours of work this week. I found another note from Ryan on my door this morning. This time, a threat. She continues to surprise. She's smarter than she looks. And then later, she confronted me by the couch in the lounge and handed me another of her threats. I didn't bother taking it with me.
Maybe we could find that by the couch in the lounge.
Well, as is, it's little more than a plaything. I can't get the proper flow using the original design. I've got schematics drawn up for an entirely new prototype. But maybe that step isn't necessary. The math is solid, and the small-scale experiments are running at an efficiency of about 80%, and that's using the old design. I checked in on Mason's work today. He has the strangest attraction to exactly the work I'd most like him to avoid. I'm starting to question if he knows what he's toying with. I've made my message to him clear, yet he keeps going back to the rough materials application portion of the process. Perhaps it's time Gray tightens up the network to keep him in line. Maybe it's time to replace him. He's been less of an asset than I expected anyway.
Ooh. Ryan was threatening him. Mason's useless, which I'm happy to hear.
I'm finding myself spending more and more time down in my study in a state somewhere near sleep. Viewing the schematics in my mind, looking for flaws, doesn't make sense that I'm finding none.
Okay. The couch in the lounge. Maybe we can find it, but I don't know. Well, was that it? If turning wasn't so horrible. There we go. Unless you're dying to see the inside of a body bag, I suggest you rethink your plans. I like the paper though. You're smart enough to know what's going to happen if you don't stop. Nico, consider what I'm saying. If you run the coil in that configuration, it's going to kill you. Okay, it's less of a threat and more like you're playing with fire. Okay. For the last time, no. If you make me do this, you're going to end up dead. She's not threatening him. She's saying, this is dangerous, and if you make me fix the coil in this way, you're going to get electrocuted,
Whoa,
which he did.
Up on this.
I'll be personally accepting my award at the Visionaries in Science conference on the night of the 24th. They certainly believe I can do what I say. You better as well. Okay, there's a little bit of a threat as well. But it honestly did not seem that bad. Not as bad as he was making it out to be.
Check. Did that. Did that. Haven't done that.
Okay, we've still got to view the security video mentioned in the case file.
Can't check that off yet.
Alright, let's go and see if we can ask Ryan what the heck she was doing.
I found these notes in the lounge. Is this your handwriting?
Yes.
So you admit to threatening Nico?
It looks like a threat, but it really isn't.
What else could it possibly be? It says right here.
I know what it says.
Then what?
A warning. It
yeah, it wasn't that
it
much
says.
Of a threat.
He wanted me to build something that could kill him. I had to make sure he knew what he was working with.
Do you have anything to prove that's true?
You know what? I need you to leave me alone right now. Go, please.
Oh, I got kicked out. Let's be naughty and press the button. Okay, but I need to get... I've got the video reference from the case notes here somewhere. Actually, I might go back and arrest Ryan anyway for being a tryhard. Okay, security video LBTY. Okay, I've got that written down. I was just checking it was correct. Oh, I pressed the button for no reason, because nobody's in. That's just... Can I unpress it? I'll just go to bed. Oh, here's a bit of the cat. Oh, I don't think I... Oh, can I? It's this, isn't it? Right, let's go to nighttime. I want to ask Deirdre some questions.
Hey there, Nancy Drew.
Ryan's been sneaking into the facility. I think she might be trying to avoid ending up in the security logs.
Just spitballing here. But do you think you could take her in a fair fight?
What kind of question is that?
The kind of question you ask someone who is kicking it with killers.
You seem pretty certain she's guilty.
The first thing you learn in criminology is that most cases are easy. The person who looks guilty usually is.
Ryan was threatening Nico. I found one of her notes.
What's it say?
Unless you're dying to see the inside of a body bag, I suggest you rethink your plans.
I admire the directness. Well, good. I was hoping.
Well, she only put the one that sounded bad.
Ryan says the notes were taken out of context.
Say what now?
Yep.
Yeah, in my experience, no one buys that line.
I feel like the other notes then clarify that it wasn't a threat. Well, Deirdre is actually Nancy's enemy. She appears in one other game as she's a suspect. And she's after Nancy's boyfriend. She loves Ned.
Ryan told me she was interviewed by the police and that she's still considered the prime suspect.
Okay.
Is that common in murder investigations?
It can be. The police have to be fairly Never. Certain before they can charge her. But usually it means that they're missing a piece or two of their case and they're just waiting for the suspect to slip up.
But she just doesn't seem the type.
The truth Never. Is, there isn't a type. Most killers aren't like what you see on television. They're not like mustache twirly or anything. They're usually scared. They've convinced themselves there's no other way out of whatever mess they've gotten themselves into. My prof always says there's no place for feelings in a murder investigation. There's only alibi, evidence, and motive. And right now, Ryan's coming in as a heavy favorite.
You read up on the case, right? I don't Ned's understand the best. Why Ryan was under so much scrutiny, but never sent to trial.
From what I gathered, something didn't add up with the video and the timeline. Someone had to be in the lab with Nico. Otherwise, he'd still be here today.
So, if her alibi stands up, it couldn't be her.
Exactly. Unless there's something big I'm missing.
Something's weird about this whole thing.
Well, don't keep me in suspense. Figure this out.
I asked her about the night of the murder. She was pretty much mute. I'm undercover here. I can't push too hard. Can you see what you can find on your end?
I'll see what I can find.
Okay, she might find
All I've
something
got
for
is
us.
The database. Don't expect any miracles.
Why are Kona and I the only ones who like Ned? But fortunately, we have all the power, and the Ned command is positive. She's just Nancy's rival, I guess, but like not really. Like, she doesn't actually want anything bad to happen to Nancy. It's just kind of like a high school rivalry, and they're like 1 year. They're meant to be like just graduated high school, I think. So like they're kind of over it now, but like keeping hold of it for all time's sake. That's the vibes I get. Hi, Doc Sauce. Okay, now we sneak in. Wait, what did I want to do? I wanted to look at some videos. I wanted to look at LBTY 51025. So this is the guy going in. And then he dies.
Just Nico. Hmm.
This is a real mystery. And we need to figure out this password. There's these things everywhere, and I'm wondering if these numbers have got to do with it. Yeah, but the only way to turn it on is within that room, and they don't have anything recorded. Oh, we'll have to get Kona to make a BAM command. BAM! Kona makes all the commands here. I don't know how to do anything.
Did that.
I pressed the start streaming button. That's me. Yes, command for BAM. Haha.
Hi.
She's the only one I kind of like, which kind of makes me suspect her
go.
A bit.
Goodbye, Nancy.
But it could equally be the guy who's set us up, the co-owner.
Victor here.
Did you know about Nico's diaries?
I knew he kept audio notes in his office. He had a player there. No clue how it works.
Did you know Ryan was threatening Nico?
Do you have proof?
I found a note, but she claimed it was a warning, not a threat.
Likely story. It'd be very convenient for her if you believe that.
I'll let you go.
Bye.
Also, it was in Ellie's desk that we found Nico's diary, which is kind of suspicious. Weird bird. Okay, I'm a little bit confused on what to do now. We've like spoken to everyone as much as possible. This guy still hasn't fixed that beeping. Yeah, apparently they all hated him. Nico was bad. No one liked him. I feel like we need to break into that computer, but I don't really know how. I don't really know why it lets us zoom in on this either. Hint, please. I think it's to do with all those random letters that seem to be everywhere in bubbles, but I don't really know how to join them up. Is this the control booth? I don't think so. Yeah, they're not exactly the best either. I probably wouldn't be that pleasant to them. Oh, see, yeah, I knew it. The stickers with a single number or letter inside will spell out the password, and there's 12 of them. Okay, let's do it based on that. I kind of don't want to go in there now because he will see. I think there was some in like Ryan's room, so we could go to sleep. Find them. Yeah, I just think it's the guy who hired us, because
Nancy,
it makes sense.
Ryan's alibi stands up. She couldn't have killed Nico.
What? How do you know?
She told the police that she won an award. That was her alibi. But it left her with enough time to sneak back in. It wasn't airtight. Close, but not perfect. There was nothing in the crime database. But I had a hunch. I went to the journalism lab and used their photographer database. The ceremony was a national story, so a bunch of freelancers put their shots up for sale.
You found pictures of Ryan, but what does that prove?
By itself, nothing. But two, count them, two different photographers submitted photos of Ryan standing near a visible clock.
She couldn't have made it back in time.
Yes. That was the finale I was building to and was excited to get to say out loud that you interrupted.
Oh, Deirdre, you're amazing.
That is a genuine compliment. Okay.
Same, Pogo.
I'm working on tracking down the photographers, but it could take weeks. For now, it looks like Ryan's in the clear.
Or Ellie, because she's the only nice, decent one. And that would make sense.
I don't know who to focus on now that Ryan's been cleared.
I can't help you there. Whoever did this was very calculating. It's sort of too bad that the rest of your suspects are scientists.
If I didn't know better, I'd say you were starting to enjoy working with me.
No. It's just that I'm bored and I'm completely out of episodes of TDPD.
TDPD? Is that a... What is that?
The best show on television ever. And you've never heard of it? Nancy, he was a linebacker and now he's a crime tracker.
What?
Ring a bell? Officer Downs? Anything?
Sorry, never heard of it.
Sometimes it's like you live on Mars.
Bye.
Bye.
Nancy doesn't need to watch crime dramas. She is the crime drama. Okay, I guess we call Victor. See what he has to say about it, about this.
Nancy, hi.
I found a way to prove that Ryan's innocent. It wasn't her.
What? What do you mean?
See, he's angry.
Photos from her award ceremony prove she couldn't have made it to the lab in time. It's not possible.
That can't be true. All of that evidence, I'm sure it was her.
Deirdre's working on getting the photos over to the police now.
They'll reopen the case and everything will just stall out again.
Okay, what's my next move then?
I don't know. I have to think.
He's angry.
That's done.
He really wanted us to find it was Ryan.
Yes.
I better get going.
Goodbye.
Okay, thank goodness we don't have to talk to him. Sorry I got mad. Stop by. I want to talk. Ryan. Is she gonna murder me and prove us all wrong?
Hi.
You really are innocent.
I'm sorry I ever doubted you.
Don't be sorry. It's the smartest course of action. Look, I gotta ask you. You're not really here for a new investor. You're here to look into what happened to Nico, aren't you?
I say we say yes, because we know it's not her. We knew that from the beginning, but we can trust her, I think.
Yes. I figured the questions you were asking were a little odd considering. I believe someone from this lab killed Nico. Anything you need from me, you got it.
Why are you being so helpful?
Nico may have had some crazy, downright dangerous ideas, but he was a good man. His killer deserves to be punished, whoever it is.
Mason says he was tormenting you with a cat because you hit it. Is that true?
It was self-defense! Fuzzy little freakball had it coming.
Bye.
Later.
She's growing on me a bit, but her introduction was awful. She just came across like she was trying to be cool. Huh? Oh no! The killer got me! Oh no. It's timed. Mason and Ellie, should you need it and I'm not available, I loaded the program on the computer next to the etcher. How do I get out of here?
Hello?
Nancy? Is that you? Are you okay?
I'm locked in!
Me too!
Oh no!
There's no air flowing in! How do I get out?
It's going out so fast!
Oh no! It's locked!
What do I do? This key? Okay. I'll take that too. What's this? I don't even know what I'm supposed to do.
Check.
It's going down so fast.
Oh no, it's locked.
Try looking up.
It's pretty hot in here. I better find my way out as quickly as possible.
Oh my god. How? I don't know. This is the worst.
What are you doing here?
Back off, old man.
I said, what are you doing here? And while I'm at it, what's in the bag?
And I said, back off! Hey!
Silence up some oxygen.
I don't want to see you here screwing around after hours.
Are you crazy? This is mine! Leave me alone!
Yeah, you better run!
What were they arguing about?
What about Ellie? Is she okay?
Did that?
It makes me suspect Ellie. Yeah, kind of, but... Why is Mason here after hours? That's the only time I've been able to get in the lab. Every other time,
it's locked.
I haven't managed to actually get in there yet, so that's interesting.
Did that?
She's completely fine. But you know, Nancy didn't even bother to check or call for help immediately. But it's funny how we told the co-owner that it's not Ryan and then we get bashed over the head and attempted murdered.
strange. What's Ellie up to with this?
Curl up with some good books. Oh, this is going to be the books in the lounge. Condemned Elephant Name. Tesla's Good Friend. Element. Okay. We can do that. We read that before. Okay, let me write down these things that we want. Condemned Elephant's Name. I don't think we've read about elephants yet. B equals IR. Tesla's Good Friend. It's not Thomas Edison, am I right? Element 74, we can easily get that. Incorrect radio patent holder. Oh, yes. We'll be able to find that in the Tesla book. Sagramore's Fellow Knight. Okay, yeah, that's a book on her desk, I think. So maybe we should go back. Is it Lancelot? Okay. I'll save because that was tense. Okay, we can get element number 74. There's a periodic table here. Tungsten. Let's go to the Tesla book. Yeah, this Guglielmo Marconi, is that it? Okay, 1893 Colombian. Oh, he was good friends with Mark Twain. He wants it to end because Nico's a scientist and all his work is being held, all his papers, all his notebooks, everything, all the important work is being held by the police, so he wants the investigation to end so that's released and they can continue working. But Nico was a co-owner with Victor. Money. Yep. Oh no. You got caught for spam. How could sound alerts call you out like this? And oh, hey, yeah, you're alive. What? A catch part. Okay, we need the name of a condemned elephant. I'm pretty sure this is about like the electrical experiments they did on animals, but I don't know. Ooh. Okay, yeah, so like Marconi, that'll be the order. Yep. I think, what's the elephant going to be called? Topsy. Yeah. We don't even have to know. We just pick out the one that sounds like an elephant. And Chimkin, who possibly knew. So, 1893 Colombian Expo site. What sounds like an expo site? Yeah, they, sadly, yes. I knew that they did do that, but I did not know the elephant's name. And then we need V equals IR. So this one and this one. We've got all the others. That elephant was my father. Sorry to hear that, Chimkin. Thank you for the electricity that I am now using to stream. Oh, maybe it's on here. No. I can't recall any other books. Maybe in electronics? Nope. I don't think so anyway, because I ain't reading all that. Probably going to have to at some point, but until that day. Oh, here's another book. Oh, that's just on biometrics. About how we're going to steal fingerprints by making a jelly finger or something. Stop the madness. Okay, I'm going to attempt to just cheese it again. Ow. I just headbutted the microphone. So it would be Topsy. V equals IR. What does it say? I'm going to use real life Google. That existed in 2012. Oh, it's Ohm's law. Okay, so then it's Ohm's. In Chicago, okay. We got this. Nancy could use Google, she just refuses to. Okay, let's just back out and restart. So Topsy, Ohms, Mark Twain, Tungsten, Marconi, where's Chicago? Ooh. Another journal. And a notebook. See, that's two things regarding Nico's diary that Ellie has had the clues to. Unless somebody's putting that on her desk. It's kind of suspicious. Faraday cage is starting to fail. Have sent a materials request to Victor. Oh my gosh, they put us in the Faraday cage. And they knew it was failing. May need to refabricate the cage before winter. Ellie should be made aware of the issue, of course. As long as it's only the two of us using the coil, it should hold for a little while longer. Reminder, call Victor to have him expedite the materials before something disastrous happens. Need photosensitive paint, Faraday materials, magnets, USB drives, science desk at Tribune, fabricating stories about my work, add to media blacklist. More research materials are missing today. Keep closer watch
what
on Ellie.
What is Nico working on? Is this some sort of code?
Oh. Okay.
Still have to do that.
Well, let's listen to his second diary first.
Friday. The hours have gone negative this week. The news of the announcement has gone far beyond what I wanted. I've lost control over it, and we're not ready. Gray's been helping me comb through all the unsuitable work. I've had to step up my own security. I can't be too careful now. The mood in the lab has been tense for a long time, but there has been a shift. A sudden calmness to my enemies as of late, as if they're planning something. Paranoia has always come creeping into the back reaches of my mind when I stretch myself too far, but I've not been overextended. Quite the opposite. Everything has been going smoothly with the energy project. This, I fear, isn't paranoia. I find myself unable to trust anyone here, but I can't leave the work, not until it's announced. There's electricity in everything, but we don't know how to see it because we perceive it to be scarce, always looking for exotic solutions. Exotic and costly. Victor once warned me to take it easy with the announcement. The world economy is built on expensive energy. To flood the market could cause a collapse. But to continue to hide the resources we have, to deprive those who need them, I see why Tesla liked his pigeons. They fly only where they're directed, and never question the effect the beating of their wings will have on the skies and the world below.
Okay, well, that kind of opens up that he could have been murdered by basically the whole world because he found a cheap way of producing electricity. The sequel to the movie of our life was crazy, Tilted Topsy's Revenge and Elephant Never Forgets. Please tell me that isn't real. Please.
Check.
Let's confront Mason about what he was doing there when we got bashed over the head.
Yes?
You were here the other night.
So what if I was?
Someone attacked me.
You think it's me? It wasn't, okay?
Why do you seem so nervous?
Shouldn't I be if someone's attacking people?
Bye.
Goodbye.
Good job confronting him, Nancy.
What are you doing?
Good job.
Hi.
I was locked in the photo lab. I think someone tried to kill me.
The air was off.
Yeah, I had to crawl out the vent.
No one was trying to kill you.
How can you be so sure?
The only one who knew about the air cycling off was me. I'm working on the vent system. If someone locked you in, they weren't trying to kill you.
Then what were they trying to do?
I don't know, but I'll make sure the air stays on. Still, be careful out there.
Bye.
Later.
I don't know, Ryan.
I'm still missing parts. Okay. I need to find them first.
Sounds pretty suspicious. I was ready to call it a day on her, but that was weird. What the heck is this code? Okay. We need to try and find the password to the computer. About the stickers. Oh, I just can't be bothered to collect them. Start at the 12 o'clock position. Just give me the solution. I keep forgetting to go and look at them. There's some I can only access in the day. Yeah. I don't know. If somebody had just pushed Nancy in and she hadn't seen who it was, I would think, yeah, okay, maybe they weren't trying to kill her. But they literally knocked her out and put her in the only room without air. Fantastic. I can't read. I actually can't read when letters are that close together. Oh, my eyes. Okay, now we can do this one. It's based on this puzzle, this piece of paper we got. Okay, let's try. So... is this one actually over anything? Like that? No, like that. And then... oh no, I think... no? Which one is this one? Or is it just got like so many colours over it that you can't tell what it is? I say. I'm trying to get that like ready colour there. I don't really know how. What's this one? The guy's gonna walk in. I'm gonna get caught. I'm honestly not interested in this at all. I can't figure out what that colour is. The guy's gonna walk in, I'm gonna get caught. Okay, so I think this has gotta be first. Like, ah, there we go. And then we can put the yellow one in. That. Or is this one... I don't know if that one was actually meant to be... no, it's like that. Then this one. The blue one? Like that? There? And there? No, it can't be like that. Like that?
I need a blank key card first.
Oh. Blooming heck. If this makes me redo it. Okay, we've got a key to the lab. Okay. It's okay. Yeah, I was about to lose it too, don't worry. I was like, I'm never gonna not be able to do that again. That took everything in my brain.
Still have to do that. That's done.
Okay, can we use it on here? This?
I need a car to get in the lab.
Oh, hell yeah. Okay, we get to explore an area that we've not been in yet. Let's save. Science is good. Oh no, we're gonna have to do science. Oh, we're gonna have to make solutions. No, why?
Something must be broken.
This is where we got locked in. Okay, a 3D printer. Ooh, this is the coil itself.
Time to replace the capacitors like Ryan's note in the book described.
Pardon? I'm doing what now? This? Nancy, you're not an engineer. Okay. The lower voltage stress, we replace the old single cap with a multi-miniature capacitor matrix. MMC will charge only when there is no other cap of a similar colour rating in the same row or column. Ryan replaced part in spark gap with one made to her modifications. Note for future tests, now coil won't run without the new part in place. Okay, so they just can't be... Okay... They can't be in the same row or column, but they can rotate. Travesty. I'm gonna sue for emotional damages. Ooh. Oh no, I've already made an error. Can't go there. Can't go there. We'll leave you out of this. How about that? We'll go with that. Is that okay? I like your fear of rotating pieces and puzzles. Well, you just know it's like twice as hard now. Because this rotates two ways. No! I'm suing! No! I'm suing! I'm doing it. I'm being emotionally tortured by the Nancy Drew development team. No. I refuse. To be fair, this could go there. No. 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 Well, let's put this one in first because this one has to be. This one's a big stretch, so there's only like two options. And so I basically think, because this one's second longest, it has to be similar. Oh, I guess there's this one too, but. Okay. I think that's okay so far. And then the only piece that can go with that is this one. Okay, up to there. This looks good. It looks good. Can't be that. It's Friday night, baby. It certainly is. How are you doing, Siri? Oh no, that one's got.
All right.
Yes, Nancy's a genius.
It looks like something is missing.
I'm so good. I'm so good, thank you. This is the Faraday cage that's barely working.
Have the clues I need. Ooh. Time to figure out the correct sequence.
I do. Let's try and do this, like, you know, this can't be this one. The red shape is pressed neither first nor last. The blue shape is a star. Okay. Okay, just checking there was only one type of blue. The purple shape isn't pressed first. Okay. The square isn't red. The purple shape, the diamond and the circle are pressed in order. The triangle is pressed second. Oh my god. The green shape is immediately after the diamond. So the circle is the green shape then. And that means the diamond isn't purple. Wait. Yeah. The circle is green. The circle is pressed before the yellow shape. Oh no. The yellow shape is pressed last. Okay, that makes sense. Triangle is pressed second. So that's not yellow. Triangle is not yellow. The triangle could be purple. Triangle. The triangle. And then the yellow shape is pressed last. So that could be the square. And then the diamond is red. Triangle's pressed second. No, I think that's wrong. Then I've gone wrong somewhere. The yellow shape last, I think, is right. Purple shape, the diamond. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. But what's pressed first then? The star? This star surely is made for children. Well, joke's on the children, because I did it.
Still have to do that. Did that.
So somebody could have been up here waiting for him, because he wasn't, he was down there. He died down there, I think. And then somebody was up here, and then they pressed the button. Ellie's notes on Tesla coil safety. Tesla, choose power level. Power on. Charge power. This machine is deadly. Do not exit control booth while high-level tests are in progress. If on the floor during high-level tests, stay in the Faraday cage. Use caution when exiting booth while low-level tests are in progress. Always discharge capacitors before working on coil. Gona! I'm smarter than a child! Safety systems reintegrated and confirmed working, restarting testing tomorrow. Occasional surges observed, source unknown, testing on hold until source of problem confirmed. Cause of technical difficulty still undiagnosed, but gave required coil demonstration per Victor's demand. Some discrepancies in power levels still observed. Oh my gosh! So when Victor said he'd make Ellie give me an experiment, that cage they put me in was both failing and they had power surges. Kona, I hope you enjoyed your non-nap. Some discrepancies in power levels still observed. When I came back after getting rid of that annoying assistant, parts missing from coil, have to track them down again. They don't call me the annoying assistant for nothing. Right, we're missing a part, so there's not much point. We're missing the LE specific part. Oh, are we going to have to 3D print that? Mason had the program on his computer to do it.
That must be where the switch goes.
Yeah, this. We're gonna have to 3D print that.
Did that.
Okay, I guess I don't know if we've got we're able to. Ooh.
I need to get this to add up correctly.
She has a note in that book. What's this?
I need to figure out whose card this is.
Okay, we've got a lot to do. She's... This. Each set equals 15. This is going to be for her phone, I'm guessing. Hello, JCat. Welcome. First time chat. Where I'm just about smart enough to solve a few Nancy Drew puzzles. Okay, each set equals 15. So like that would equal 15 and across there equals 15. Hello, Moomin. I don't think I would be smarter than a fifth grader, to be honest. But what's that number at the top of it? It was 198257112. Nine. What makes 15 then? Nothing good could come from the middle number being one. Surely. Why do you guys keep saying light? They like to yell each other's names. So they're yelling the name of Light Demoniac. Demoniac. That's me. That's her. Eight, five, 13, 2. I think 5 is a good number to have in the middle. 7, 5. Yeah.
I thought they hated each other. What's going on here?
Got New York on the phone. I'll conference you in. Can't right now. Fine, I'll handle it. Can you meet up tonight? Not until after my work's finished. Your stupid schedule. Make it early AM. K. Palo Alto said no. Big surprise. Chicago group. You work on Chicago. Their lead researcher hates me. Because you were awful to her. Okay, I'll do it. So they're trying to sell something or try and get new jobs somewhere. Are you a big Nancy Drew player? I guess. I like the games. I'm not very good at them. And, you know, I'm not very quick at finishing them, but I enjoy them all. This one, I like that it's a murder. It's a bit different. I hate all the characters, but in a good way. Yeah, I'm interested. I'm not a pro. I am not. Chicago says maybe they seem leery. Oh, I'm too scared to be super rich. Chicago. They said there are holes in the theory. They're trying to play you. But there are holes in the theory. If you can't understand the material, just say so. What? Anyway, if there are holes now, nothing we can do. Should have thought of that when Nico was alive. Well, we didn't, so now it's on you. I've got enough on my plate. And I don't. Fine, I'll take care of everything you can't handle, as usual. Nice comeback. Ooh. What are they up to?
did that.
What's my favourite? What's our favourite? Yeah, what's your favourite? Like, you like Curse of Blackmoor Manor, right? My favourite... I do like Alibi and Ashes. And I liked... I haven't played this one on stream, but I like the Waverly Academy one. Least favourite, Shattered Medallion. Easy. Actually, I liked Phantom of Venice. I liked that one a lot, and not just because of the cat dancing. Okay, can we find out who the owner of this card is by putting it into the card reader? In the office. I liked Castle Molloy, I liked the puzzles, I liked the setting, I liked the characters, but I did not like that it didn't have, like, a bad guy. This tell me who this belongs to?
This was the card that opened the lab the night of the murder. This might be important evidence. I can't alter it.
Oh. I just did.
Did that?
Did I? I got the number of it, but I guess I need to look at it who it was. I should have written that down. Go back in. Okay, 1, 8. Can I figure out who that was based on the logins? I can't see anyone with that login.
Can't leave the card behind.
Well, why don't you just pick it up yourself, Nancy? Well, I only don't like it because one of my favourite things is trying to guess who it is. That's like one of my favourite parts.
That's done.
Okay.
Did that. That's done. Still have to do that.
Right, we've just got to repair the Tesla coil. Wait, what floor am I on? Okay, let's go to bed. Then... talk to people. Enjoy your burr, but like... Castle Molloy is up there though. I thought it remained consistent throughout. Some of them don't. Ryan! Ryan!
I found a card in Mason and Ellie's office that was used to get into the lab the night Nico died.
Why would that be there?
Well, I don't know yet.
They both have their reasons to be angry at Nico.
Reasons? Like what?
He believed that scientific breakthroughs belong to everybody. Technology should be shared freely.
That's noble.
He took it to an extreme. He didn't put a dollar value on his work or anyone else's. Rumor has it, he would incorporate their work into his own without asking. I don't think he understood what he was doing to them. He's a big name, with stable funding. They're just scraping by, and Ellie's got major debt.
Do you think either one of them could have killed Nico?
This place is like a fortress. It had to be someone associated with the lab. So the way I see it, there's a 66% chance it was one of them.
I need to rebuild the missing part from the large Tesla coil. Can you help me out?
I think I've got the plans here.
Okay, yeah, yep. We're going to make it on the 3D printer. Yep.
Thanks.
Thank you. Working here, I forgot that phrase existed.
Do you know how I can get the little Tesla coil in the lab to work?
The circuit board is shot. You seem like you know what's up. I bet you could make a new one yourself. You'll find everything you need in the photo lab.
I'll let you go.
Bye.
So I have to make a circuit board and the missing part. My science brain. I'm being tested. See if Mason's got anything to say for himself.
Hey.
What were you and Ellie doing spending time together?
We weren't.
I know for a fact you were.
For a fact? Well, I know for a fact. You're wrong. Let me get back to work.
Oh, Angie.
Back already? If you'd like, I could draw you a conversational exit map.
Is this your card?
Mine has my name on it.
I better get going.
See you later.
I'm gonna need you to get off your computer. Yeah, I haven't seen her since Pogo. Which kind of makes me want to. I need to go to night time anyway so I can use his computer to make the model, so let's see. I don't even know where she was stuck. There
glad
she is.
You made it through that lock-in. That could have been real, real bad.
Finny Winny!
What happened back there in the lab?
Finny Winny's here.
Know. You're lucky you got
hello,
out.
Hello, baby.
Really lucky.
What? Tell me more.
Are you happy at this job?
Of course.
Victor seems to think your heart's no longer in your work. Is there any truth to that?
Much as I'd like to say no, all my life I was the brainy one. At home, at school, on the bus, in the library, in the corner store.
I know that feeling.
Kids used to call me Watson.
Watson?
That little brat, Susie Watkins, started calling me elementary, my dear Watson.
Well, that makes her more of a nerd.
Because I made the mistake of correcting Miss Heinz in front of the class one time. But that was a mouthful. Became Watson after a month or so. Shouldn't have called her a brat. I take it back.
Is this your card?
Nope.
Mason said it isn't his either.
Then it must just be an extra.
Oh.
Why were you spending time with Mason? I thought you two didn't get along.
We have to meet up to coordinate experiments once in a while.
You and Mason are working on a project together. Something secret.
You're wrong.
Then you won't mind if I tell Victor what you're up to?
You'd be smart not to. He doesn't have patience for people stirring up the bottom of a river that's best kept still.
Oh, Ellie's turning on us. She was the only nice one, and now she's getting a bit sassy.
After Nico died, you left for a while.
That's true.
Where did you go?
Home.
You mean back to where you grew up?
Of course. I wouldn't call Colorado home.
Why not?
Between you and me, I'm looking to get out of here as soon as possible.
Why?
Even if what happened to Nico never happened, Colorado never welcomed me with open arms.
Why do you think that is?
I honestly don't know.
When you left, I understand you took all of your work with you.
It's my work. I need to keep it safe.
Keep it safe? From whom?
I just meant, in general.
What made you decide to come back?
The police.
Did they force you to come back?
They were persuasive. I don't know if they were going to force me back, and I really didn't want to find out.
This card I found, according to the record, it's the one that opened the lab the night Nico died.
What do you mean?
It's in the log.
That was just a glitch. The video shows just one person entering the lab, Nico.
Yeah, so everything we found of Nico's has been on her possession, so...
What were you doing with Nico's things?
How did you find those?
So you were hiding them?
Stay out of my things, hun. You don't know what you're messing with.
We got hunned!
If you don't like the work, why are you still here?
I don't know. Growing up, everyone had these high expectations that I'd go out and make something big of myself. What no one knew was, much as my mind loved the inside of a book, my heart loved nothing more than being with my family. Especially my cousin Rachel. My Graham used to say the two of us put a little extra spin on the world. Rachel was my best friend, and I'd give all I've got to go back to those days. But I was told to go and fulfill my potential. And I did.
You could always just go back home.
Funny. Everyone always says the opposite. We weren't rich, and school wasn't cheap. I took out some big loans that my Graham put up the farm for. Can't make the money I need back home in the sticks.
Oh.
It's not all bad. I get to do my part in making the world a better place. That's a happy thought I can take to my pillow each night.
You never said why you hid some of Nico's work.
I'm not supposed to have them, but I see you get that. If you have to ask why I'd go out of my way to understand how someone like Nico thought, then you obviously don't realize what a big deal he is. That, and he wanted to keep them from Mason. He hated Mason.
Did he say why?
Honey, would you ask anyone to explain why they hate Mason?
True. I hate Mason. Yeah, honestly, I don't know who it is in this one. I really can't say. They are all kind of awful. And that's why you can't really pin one of them down. I originally thought she was kind of suspicious because she was the nicest to us, but now she's turning a bit cold. So...
Did you think Nico's work was important?
Not was. Is.
Important enough to kill for?
Yes. More than once.
Whoa. What do you mean by that?
Look around. Life isn't just life anymore. It's plugged in all the time. People live in this weird dream world of their own creation. We're running out of power. And fast. Imagine the jolt when we all wake up together. Nico cracked it. A way to harvest the electricity that's already there all around us. Or, so I heard. I never saw his work. His work is so important, it can't be measured in money. It's pure power. Economic, political, military, and literal power beyond measure. Wars have been fought for far less.
Yeah, and that's the thing. There's also, obviously it's going to be one of the people we've come up with, like we've come across, but it could literally be anyone if this situation were real. Because, yeah, he's created something, potentially, that people would kill for.
Can you walk me through what happened the night Nico died?
This isn't something I should talk to you about.
You don't have much of a choice.
Oh, Nancy.
May not have much, but I got a little. Leave me alone, could ya?
According to the police report, Nico had been dead for 30 minutes before you called 911. What happened?
I tried, but the phones were out.
What about your cell phone?
I must have left it at home that night.
Oh.
Bye.
Bye.
Convenient. Nico got... Mason got mad at us for messing up his desk. It was funny.
I need to rebuild Ryan's part.
No. Okay. I don't like this at all. And then... Okay, so that's this bit, okay. That's there, so then if we do... that. This is actually way more brain intensive. Yeah, that's what I'm trying to do, but I... I'm getting confused already, to be honest. The third layer. No. One of these. There we go. That. That could be interesting, Bam. I'm just putting that there because I can't really remember what I'm doing. It's really confusing where they go. I've got to tell you that. Tell you that for free. Okay. Not that one, I don't think. But this one? Not that. Is that filled in there? Thank you. This one's got one under it, I think. Layer 2. But I just can't work out where it is. That. They traditionally do, but kind of go out of the way on some of them, like Castle Malloy, where it wasn't anyone. Okay, I think this one is done from this perspective. Okay. I can't really see anything that adds to it from this one either. What about when it's like that? Okay. Nope, not seeing it. Okay, how about here? Oh, this one here doesn't need to be there. That layer of that too. Is this right? I feel like this is right. Yeah, I'm gonna print it.
I think that's right.
Yes, Nancy said it's right. Okay. We need to figure out how to get the 3D printer working.
I need to connect all of the circuits.
No. Okay, what about this one though? This one's gotta be connected somehow. Okay, this section is okay. They okay. Just need to figure out how to get electricity into it now. What are you doing, Finny? Good boy. Brain working overtime. Because there's just so many options. Okay, it could be like this. And then... and maybe you've got to be a part of something else. I think so though. Where would you go? You're a good boy, Finny. Ah, too many possibilities. This one's gotta come from here, but how? I feel like I'm so close to greatness. There you go. Okay. Just this section, what to do, what to do. Sometimes it helps to go from the power source to squares work outwards. Completely closed off spaces. Yeah. I just feel like I'm so close to something that I don't really want to undo my work. That's the trouble. I wish there was a reset button. I would do that then. Okay, I'm gonna continue for a moment because I just feel like I'm so close. But is that just is that wrong? Is that just a feeling? Is that just false hope? Coda, you're the code cracker. Crack this. then how do I get to this? And this. Crack this. Okay, well back out. Back out. No, I think it's just kept it. all the times that you go out for Nancy Drew puzzle and it doesn't save, and the one time that you want it to. Okay. We just got this one. How do I get? You do this, Coda. This is for you. You're so close, I know. I know, that's the painful part. I just can't see the next step at the minute. Should be a straight line like this, or oh, this, okay.
All done.
There, thank
now
you.
It's time to etch the
great
design.
Hint. Okay, we've got the circuit. Now, how do I make the circuit? Yeah, okay. Took you half a day to complete, eh? Is this how you make the circuit then? We're going to need to make a solution. What about the printing part though? Where's the 3D printer in here? This is where we're going to make the solution. Hello, I would like to make solution. I have a beaker. What the heck is this? I haven't even looked at this before. Yeah, I thought so. I don't even know where it's going to let me do that. This.
Something must be broken.
What even is this though? This is the little coil that she was talking about. The small Tesla coil, this one. Oh, what's this?
The red must mean it's locked. I bet if I turn everything blue, it'll open.
No, it's like that puzzle at the beginning of the game. What if I do it diagonally again? No, it didn't work this time. Enjoy your lurk, Siri. Okay. Can... I don't like that sound.
This looks
oh, here
dangerous.
You go.
I should make sure I know what I'm doing before I start.
Nah, just start mixing chemicals. I'm sure it'll be fine. Okay, which chemical do I need to use? Oh, now I'll go back to the cabinet. Ugh. You only live once. What's this? Acid? What am I making, though? Which book do I need? Is it this one? Makes sense. Makes sense. Etching solution. I feel like I've seen something about in a book about solutions, but I don't know where. I took this silicon wafer.
I need to close the box first.
What the heck is this? I just keep looking at loads of things. I have no idea what they are. What was that? What is this? What is this? What's the etching solution? What is it?
Oh, Nancy?
Ellie,
what's up?
Tell me how to
Goodbye.
Make a solution.
Goodbye, Nancy.
Okay, no. Not this one. I only just got lab access. I didn't access the lab until after I got hit on the head and got locked in the lab. I hadn't even been in there yet. Yeah. It's very non-linear, this one. Is there a book in here? Tell me. Oi, books. Tell me, what's the answer? That's the Tesla book. I can't remember where I read about the solutions. Oh. Oh, is it going to be in here?
What's he doing in there?
He's shredding. Is it this? Oh, nope. Solutions. Yay, thank you. I was like, I knew I'd looked at a book. Mix solution in the mixing beaker, not the chemical bottles. Let's not have a repeat of last June. Nitric acid, sodium hydroxide. Oh no, I still feel like I'm not going to be able to do this. I'm confused. Which one do I make? Can I make any of them? Or is it just like based on what I have access to? Oh no. Did I mean to go up here? I thought I was on the second floor. It's like how I can't remember if it's night or daytime either, and I have to go and check who's around. Okay. I've got acid. I've got a beaker. Do you like this beaker? It's water. What's this? Silicon. Oh, okay, so we do it based on this. We've got a silicon wafer. So we're going to be making hydrofluoric acid, nitric acid, and water. Nitrogen dioxide and... So we only need one part nitric acid. Can I start mixing now? Hydrogen. I'm just trying to remember my own chemistry, which is probably not a good idea. That's hydrogen fluoride, right? Which I don't think we need. Hydrofluoric acid equals hydrogen fluoride. Okay, so three of them. So I put three in them. What do I put it in? Three of them. We want four parts water. And... Can I just do that? Then... Not the nitric acid, nitrogen dioxide and water. But in what measurements? And which one's nitrogen dioxide? Is it just the N? I think just N is nitrogen. Do I not have that one? Because that's three O's, so that's not right. And it's got H, hydrogen. Or am I going to... H, or is that right? That's water. That's water and this is the acid. Okay. I've got this. Okay. I think that's right. Nothing exploded. So...
Check.
Mm-hmm.
Check.
The etching solution tank, the image tray, the tray for blank wafers. Okay. Wait, where's the tray for blank wafers? Ah. Okay, there. Can I not put that in? Or do I have to put it in order? Okay, and then this... My brain. Please be right. Nothing has exploded. Okay, how long is this going to take? It says the printing takes a while, but what about this? The photographic etching. Takes half a day, okay. What about the printing then? Where's the 3D printer? This thing? Battle of the Currents. No, thank you. Okay, but seriously, let's print that then. Okay. That one was a bit easier. Shall I just go to sleep now? Oh, I have to go. I'm going out. Oops. Sorry for the sudden one ending. I forgot I was leaving the house. We'll be back tomorrow for the end. Sorry for the abrupt ending. I'm off now. Bye.